Now, how's everybody doing? Hope everybody enjoyed the Game Awards last night. I know I did with Ark Riders, I believe it was called. Yo, that game looks interesting. And that one game from Aaron Flynn. Oh. Near the Greek Bridge. He might be over this way.
Goliath would murder us all. Mark my words.
What the deuce?
Destruction and trampled ground.
Thank you, Captain Obvious. Oh my goodness! A dead body! A dead body, ladies and gentlemen!
He was certainly under pressure.
Oof, a contortionist you were not.
Yo, porn fact, he was bald.
A belt from a dressing gown, curious. A kneecap reduced to splinters. Disjointed vertebrae. Difficult to say if it was a way to start or finish him off.
Yo, why not both? Yo, can we just get the important fact that he was bald? Dear God, my eyes! All that bald. You know, anything you see over there? Aw.
He was certainly under pressure.
Thank you, lighting. Huh. Tis be a lot of blood. Don't get it. What am I missing? Oh, the hand.
A missing pinky, middle-aged. It's none other than Theodore Gilden.
Oh boy, Sherlock. Another death means another question.
And we shall answer the question. It's far too interesting to give it up to the police.
He was certainly under pressure.
Where did this all start? Adult elephant?
Poke the elephant with this? Really? People are hopeless.
A strong pull broke this leash.
Great, so we're looking for an elephant.
A pool of blood and saliva, possibly as a result of impact.
Sherlock, take a picture of the footprint. It's valuable evidence. This photograph can help us find the old article about the elephants. The front page was fascinating. It was hard to believe as a child.
A royal suite for a favorite pet.
Plenty of food to satisfy even the most fastidious. This is quite comfy.
You know, for a guy who actually doesn't have a bottom. Can't go in. John reminded me of the newspaper article from our childhood. It was the first time I had seen the beautiful creature about 10 years. Where did I go for this? The records.
Hog heaven.
Oh, hello.
A sailor's knife useful for cutting wet and thick ropes. Coal gas tank, enough to pump up an airship. A sailor's knife useful for cutting wet and thick ropes. It's seen a lot of use. The blade is worn from grinding.
Okay.
Fresh signs of impact. A rough landing led to an altercation with this shed.
Oh boy. Well, let's start from event one. thinking. I don't think there was another person there. No. Yeah, I think he got strangled. Then we go over here, follow the path. Cause he wasn't like having enough of your shit. No. Is there a third option? Yeah, cause if he was already hit, he would be room for the hills. He'd be down and out. No.
In a fit of rage, the elephant broke the chain and threw its victim on the ground with a fierce power. Escaping the scene, it pulled the body with it, but dropped it at the gate. At least some of this was witnessed by a third party who was hurled against the shed. The elephant can't have gone too far. I can still track it.
Well, suppose you find it. Then what? Push it all the way back to the manor?
No, you push it.
He was certainly under pressure.
All right, we get it. I mean, if there's elephant tracks, you'd think it would be obvious. I hate to say it. You know what? Probably not gonna find him.
May I ask you something?
That's a question I can answer.
The elephant name is Goliath. Cross the Greek bridge in the direction of the forest where Theodore used to walk. The forest. That'd be more towards the apiary. Like, that's what at least I would think it would be near the apiary. That's a cemetery. Somehow I think it's over here. Because I do think that is the location of the apiary. Go, Sherlock, go! Save a Cordona while singing I Sharona. Sharona. This is where the crazy thing happened. The elephant Goliath may have attacked Theodore Gildon in order to break free. Let's see. There was a witness to the chaos on Gildon's property. They dropped their knife. It may have injured from the fall. Now, anybody see a mother trucking giraffe? Giraffe, not giraffe. Hold on. Dude, I swear it has to be right here. See, Gillen. Oh, hello!
Okay, hear me out. If an elephant falls in the forest and there's no one around to...
John, no.
Oh, you're such a killjoy.
There we go, Mr. Elephant. Ew. Thought that was elephant poop. Did I die? Dude, how did you? Right now I have to go all the way back because apparently 2 feet of water's gonna kill us.
Wanna go for a swim?
Yo, hello.
Strange. It was hung with care. The game has escaped us for now. We'll find a solution to the elephant problem later.
Dear Theodore, I am writing to you as a fellow islander. I value our friendship just as I value the lives of our people, although I am afraid this one-sided friendship cannot tie my hands any longer. I am being made to look weak in the eyes of your neighbors. They believe that your tree is a mockery and not a peace offering as you intended. The people are afraid. You refuse to give your elephant a proper trainer, instead using your own limited knowledge to teach it. It is an impossible situation. I admit that I did think of having the elephant forcibly taken and given to Mr. Tailheart, who has shown that he is quite capable of looking after the elephant Bean, although she is a female. Oh my god, she is a female! And far less frightened than your beast. Please reconsider the situation. Sir William Sinclair, Governor of Cordona. Yo, everybody be cool. She's a she.
Wanna go for a swim?
Alright, let's go all the way back to Theodore's house.